Well, hiya there. Welcome into VG Emporium, video game music and more. I'm the proprietor of this establishment, Rage Cage, and today we have a special going on, giant robots. And the reason, there's a couple reasons behind doing this subject, and first one is that in the suggestion box in my Discord, yes, there's a Discord for VG Emporium. I'll leave a link in the show notes if you'd like to check it out if you haven't already. The last Recon, Daryl Bowers, host of the VGM Fight Club, actually suggested that I should do a giant robot episode, and then Bedroth chimed in, and then Kung Fu Carlito of Three Heroes Podcast chimed in, and, you know, they recently had done a giant robot episode, like, a few months ago on the Very Good Music Podcast that's hosted by Red Bedroth, and, and then also, as well, I had participated in September a 7 days of VGM, which is hosted by VGM Academy, and it's been going on for I can't even remember how long now, but it was on giant robots, and you just for 7 days you come up with a theme based around giant robots, and he gave us all like prompts and stuff, and it was a fun time, and I'm actually going to be playing a couple tracks from others that had participated in this compo. So now, when it comes to giant robots, there's a few different types. There's the Super Robo, which is pretty much a sentient robot, like nobody's piloting it or anything, and it's just coming and do good. And then there's the semi-sentient ones, which there's somebody in there piloting, but the suit does have a little bit of its own will, kind of think like Evangelion. And then there are Mecha, which is actually what this episode's going to be more based around. That's kind of like, you know, like your Gundam, which actually a lot of the VGM I'm going to be playing for you are themes based around the Mecha type. Actually, the track that we opened up with is a theme from The Big O, more specifically from Super Robot Tyson D on the Game Boy Advance. And this song is called Sure Promise, originally composed by Toshihiko Sasahashi for the anime, and then arranged for the Game Boy Advance by Akihiro Juichiya, Eiji Hirasawa, and Takakako Ochiai. And truth to tell, I thoroughly enjoyed The Big O when I watched it on Toonami. Just everything about the show is like kind of like this futuristic gothic. Everybody has amnesia at some point, in giant robots, and actually, you know, the Big O, which they're called Megadeus, and it's kind of a ridiculous name, isn't it? And, kind of follows that same format, you know, stuff goes on throughout the episode, and then the big monster bad thing comes out of nowhere, and then, of course, Big O gets summoned, and this theme plays, and, on this game, there was a couple, you know, the two themes, the Big O opening theme, and then this one. And I had to go with this one because it's just like, I just really like it. It's epic, it's grandiose, and it gives me chills. I mean, listen to this. And, you know, my preteen brain, you know, seeing the combination of, like, this giant-ass, like, robot, cool-looking robot coming out of the ground on this theme playing, it's just like, oh my god, so cool! So, yes, The Big O. It actually kind of falls under the category of semi-sentient mecha giant robot. And the best way to explain this is, just a strange mashup of, like, film noir, detective fiction, and mecha. That's the best way to put it. And all the events of the show taking place in the city-state called Paradigm City, Big O is piloted by a very original name, Roger Smith, who is a negotiator. Basically, he goes and negotiates like situations, like hostage situations, money, stuff like that, you know, going on. But yeah, no, this is it's a really cool anime. I suggest you go check it out. But we're here to talk about the video game music, which is this is from Super Robot Tyson D. on the Game Boy Advance, and I'm not too familiar with the Super Robot Wars. I know it's long, big, lot of titles, and it's all focused around the super robots from anime and manga. So, starting with Gundam and Mazinger, and probably even Gigantor's in there, maybe. I don't know, but yeah, they're all in there. And Big O makes its first appearance in this game, Super Robot Tyson D. Which, from what I'd read, is kind of like a weird little side story from the main Robot Tyson series. I don't know, something, but he starts showing back up, and there are other versions, like DS version, and those are a lot cleaner sounding and stuff, but I went with this because, you know, I have a soft spot for the Game Boy Advance sound. But enough blathering. We're coming up, I'm going to play you our next track, and this is actually coming from one of the entries to the 7 Days of VGM, September 2022, Giant Robots And this is the day one entry from Haberchuk, and this is called Onward. Made using the Sega Arcade, so that being the YM2151 and the Sega PCM module in Deflamask. Onward by Haberchuk, the day one entry to 21 Days of VGM September 2022, Giant Robots. And all I gotta say is damn, these guys just keep getting better and better. And yes, Haberchuk is actually a duo, and I'm not sure which one I'm communicating with. It's either Haber or Chuck, or it could be both. They're just going back and forth, but yeah, no, it's just insane how much improvement they've been going over like the last year and a half that I've been like, you know, aware of them and know them. And yeah, they just keep making music, mostly chiptune. And they actually just did Looptober, which is a little thing they've made up to just create loops throughout the month of October. And I want to say they've done at least over 10 loops of tracks. And like, you know, they're like a minute and a half long too. It's insane just how much they're able to make. So I would highly recommend, if you're on Twitter, give them a follow there. If you're into SoundCloud, check them out there. It's like they post a lot of the music there. And yeah, just like really awesome musicians. Really awesome chiptunists, I should say. So, now a little bit about the 7 Days event. It actually started as the 21 Days of VGM, started by VGM Academy, founded by Dan Holdsman. And like, you know, the goal of it was to create this community for people who wanted to create, like, you know, become video game music composers, to learn and teach and just like kind of come together and just, yeah, just, it's really cool community. And yeah, just within the last year or so, he started doing like just 7 days of VGM, because 21 days of VGM, you know, as cool as it is to create like a song every single day for 21 days, it can get a little much. So he reduced down to the 7 days and only doing it like, you know, he was originally doing it every month and then decided to go back doing quarterly, I think. And September's thing was Giant Robots. And so the prompts were, you know, calling the giant robot or summoning the giant robo, tune up, practice, desperate battle, loss, repair, and then, you know, last battle. And Haberchuk caught that vibe of, like, you know, the day one prompt, the summoning the giant robot, perfectly. And, you know, I can't resist a song with metal hits in it. I mean, it just sounds so good, and it's just like, it's just so rocking and going. And this little spot right here, that sounds like a sample that Dia used once. Yeah, no, getting back to Haberchuck, you know, definitely his style, their style is mostly like this really rocking, kind of like heavy rock style right here. But they can get into like a lot of cool other styles, like really smooth, funky, jazzy sounds. I actually did one recently, or within that last month of Lutober, where he did like something that was kind of like Rob 2612's, which we both agree is one of our favorite Mega Drive chiptunists. And speaking of Sega Genesis composers, the next track I caught for you is from the Sega Genesis, and it actually comes at the suggestion of another Sega Genesis chiptunist by the name of Crazy Goji. And what they suggested was The River Boss from Ranger X, composed by Yoshinobu Hiraiwa and Noriyuki Iwadare. Stage 3-2, River Boss, from Ranger X, composed by Yoshinobu Hiraiwa and Noriyuki Iwadare. And this came at the suggestion of Crazy Goji in that same conversation about me doing this giant robot episode. And as I mentioned, they are another Mega Drive chiptunist. They actually, I've done a couple combos with them, like for Signcraft, and we were actually the only two to do the 2021 Signcraft Christmas compo, both of us doing Sega Genesis ones. I did mine in Deflamask, and they did theirs in a DAW using, I believe, the FM Drive 2612, which is a VST created by Ali James Labs. So it comes at no surprise that they would suggest this track, because it's a pretty dang good Sega Genesis Mega Drive soundtrack. So now Ranger X, or also known as X Franza, and it is what is called in this game a powered exoskeleton, basically, and it is a mech still. And actually, there's a couple stages where it actually shows the scale of this thing, and it is pretty big because it shows little people running past it and stuff. And it's like, you know, pretty sleek looking. It can fly around and could be on ground combat shooting. The jetpack has a limited amount of time you can use it, and then you have to do some cooldown time. And it has an assist as well. Like, you get this vehicle called the Indra, which is like a little motorcycle that you can actually get on and ride around, and it moves around and fires independently of Ranger X. And you can actually get inside of it to change your weapons as well, I believe, from what I some of the gameplay stuff I saw. And one of the cool visual features of this game is that at the beginning of each stage, it shows you like this kind of like wireframe pseudo 3D cutscene detailing like the specific target that you're going to be taking on at the end of the level. So at the end, and with this one is a river boss, and it's like this weird blob thing that just kind of hangs out in under the water and just kind of like shooting and firing things at you. And then once you drain about half of its health, it comes out as this giant floating brain thing that's just shooting more stuff at you, and you're just taking it out. And other bosses include a giant walking fortress, a multipedal cyclops robot thing. It's like this weird, you know, it's long and it has like one giant glass eye thing that shoots shit at you. Excuse the language. And the final boss, I don't know its name, but it's like this big hulking muscular thing with like kind of like a metal skull with spikes coming out of it. And it's, you know, just pretty cool looking. And a big help on that cool factor is the music. And I just now realized that I didn't talk about the composers for the Big O track, but we're already here. So the composers for this song, starting with Yoshinobu Hideiwai. He doesn't have too big of a list, Ranger X, and then, which is the only game, and then the other ones are TV series, Revive Ultraman in 1996, and then 80 Police, which is anime, in 1999, and as well as Angel Tales in 2001, and then he also did an arrangement of a song, Uncertain I Love You, in 1988 for the movie Kimigure Orange Road, I Want to Return to That Day. And so that brings us to Noriyuki Iwadare. And this fella is a self-taught musician, and prior to doing video game music starting in 1990, he had been involved with various bands of, you know, kind of jazz fusion and stuff. So he got to start doing arranged music for Afterburner 2, then went on to do music for Ease 3, Wanderers of Ease, Warsong, Star Odyssey, Headbuster, Glaylancer, Lunar, Eternal Blue, Langrisser 2, Graduation for Windows 95, sound operator for Crusader of Senti, also known as Solil, and we're actually going to circle back to that in a bit. Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, the movie, he did sound for that. Dokusai, Langrisser 4, Lunar, Silver Story Complete, Langrisser 5, Grandia 2, Grandia Extreme, Mega Man X7, Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney Trials and Tribulations, Grandia 3, he did arrangements for Super Smash Bros. Brawl, did Lunar Silver Star Harmony, and Kid Icarus Uprising, Super Smash Bros. For the Wii U, Half Minute Hero, The Second Coming, Langrisser Reincarnation Tensai, and then his final credit, which is in 2019, is Gun Gun Pixies as sound artist. Now we're circling back to Solil, and this is totally giant robot unrelated, but it is related to an episode I had done previously called Who Done It, whereas I, you know, chose a track that had an unknown composer and then chose some tracks that were composed by a confirmed composer and they sounded similar, and I kind of deducted that maybe this person composed that. But I forgot to mention for the comparison of a track from Daikyo Omowase and Solil that Noriyuki Iwadare was involved as like the sound designer, sound operator. And so it could very well be that he was the composer for Dial Q Omowase. Like, I don't know how I missed him in all the credits and stuff I was looking for. I might have just been doing it really quick. But yeah, another potential composer for Dial Q Omowase. And if you don't know what that is, go back and check out episode 28, Who Done It? And or go on to VGM Rips and look up Dial Q Omowase. It's really good. But now let's get us back to giant robots. And we're going to do that with another entry from the 7 Days of VGM Giant Robots. Actually, two entries. This is going to be coming from Toby Komi. These are pretty short tracks, so I'm actually going to be playing two of his. This first one is going to be Get Good, Day 3. And then the second one is Devil Machine, Day 4, by Toby Komi. Made with a combination of the YM2151 and Occam 6258 in Furnace Tracker. Thank you. Those were Get Good, Day 3, and Devil's Machine, Day 4, composed by Toby Comey. And they were made in Furnace Tracker using the combination of the YM2151 and the Ocam 6258, which is the combination of sound chips used in the Sharp X68K. And this is the sound that Toby Comey went with throughout all 7 days, telling a nice little cohesive story of Starstorm. And now where these two tracks fall in that 7 days of EGM is Day 3, Get Good, is Training Exercises, and Day 4, Devil's Machine, is Desperate Battle. And actually, Get Good, Day 3, makes me think of Pennant Race from Namatsuke 68. Really has that Yuji Takanuchi vibe. So now, Toby Comey. You know, one thing I'll call him is a multi-chip tunist extraordinaire. And believe you me, all his music is just purely delightful, and a lot of it sounds like it could actually belong in a game in the later years of the console that he's making the music for. You know, he has like a real understanding of the sound chips and how they work and how to kind of like get the best out of them. And hooey! You know, ever since Furnace Tracker came out, he's been making music for chips that, like, you know, before you would have to actually, like, kind of create your own software or write an MML and then run it through a driver. Now you have access to, with over 70, I think, different sound chips, and then you can even mix and match, like, you know, the sound chips together or even just parts of the sound chip. So, like, one channel from this one, put them here, up here, and make you up your own custom, like, sound. Some recent examples would be his making the music for the Wonderswan, as well as the combination of, taking the combination of two chips, three chips technically, to create the sound of the Bubble System, which was the failed Konami arcade board. So I would highly recommend you go check out his SoundCloud, and you can even find him on Battle of the Bits, where you can find all his songs. Like, he's like countless numbers of songs on there. The majority of them chiptune of various types. And you can find him on Twitter, where he not only shares his music, but also the art he creates exclusively in MS Paint, and it's really good. And he is open for commissions, so definitely do check him out. Alright, moving on to our next giant robot, this one also being a mech, Orbital Frame to be exact. This is coming from the game Zone Avengers 2, The Second Runner. This is Balrom Battleship, composed by Akihiro Honda, Maki Kirioka, Norihiko Hibino, and Toshiyuki Kikuta. heard Ballroom Battleship from Zone Avengers 2 Second Runner, composed by Akihiro Honda, Maki Kirioka, Norihiko Hibino, and Toshiyuki Kakuta. And I gotta say, this is probably one of the funnest games I played on the PS2. It's just frenetic, all the weapons you have at your disposal to use that on your enemies, or just get up close and hit them with your laser blade that comes out, and you know, all your melee attacks, and it's just wacky fun time. And it helps that the mech that you control, Jehuti, is just really cool looking, really sleek. Think Ava's in space, but with no organics part of being part of the mech, or all that weirdness that goes on in that anime. Nope, what Jehuti is what's called an orbital frame, which is a mech that is powered by this energy source called Metaton, and of course it can just, like, you know, go in space, it can fly around, it's usually very humanoid in appearance, like, you know, in shape. It has legs, but it doesn't have feet at the end. It's like got these pointy things, so when you get on the ground, it just kind of like balances, and when you move around on the ground, you kind of like slide glide around with, like, you can see this kind of like the laser sparks kind of like going around trailing after you. But the orbital frames are only few. The mechs that are actually used by, you know, normal everyday like grunts, so like soldiers and workers and everything, are called lev suits, which are bulkier, slower, squatter, you know, kind of imagine like Zaku versus Gundam. And another major thing that sets the orbital frames apart is the AI that is within them. In this case, Jehuti has an AI called Ada, which controls all the functions of the Jehuti. Like, of course, you're piloting it, and the pilot controls it, but Ada is like overseeing all, like, everything in there, and actually has dialogue with you as well as you're going through. So it's kind of one of the cooler parts of the game, is while you're going through, battling, fighting, like, she'll actually tell you, like, you know, the different, like, frames that are coming at you, like the raptors or mummies, whatever. And she'll let you know when they're destroyed, when you're, like, collecting stuff. No, it's just, like, it's, for some, it might be some kind of, like, you know, overstimulation, overload with all this noise and frenetic and flashing and stuff going on. But for me, it was, like, really just, like, oh, man, I was just really into it. Ah, and I forgot to mention who the pilot was. It's a great name. It's Dingo Egret. White-haired, hot-blooded, I don't give a shit about nobody until I'm forced to kind of guy. Now, the game that came before it, of course, Zone of Enders, was a pretty cool game, though. It was like the action was a little slower, the translation, you know, like the localization wasn't all that great, story was short, just like this one, but Zone Avengers 2 just greatly enhances upon, or improves upon, everything. Like, you know, the action is faster, tighter, the localization is a really big step up, yet the big complaint of it was that it was too short. I believe that it was just right. It wasn't too short, it wasn't too long, it just, like, you know, it didn't overstay its welcome, and, you know, I played through it a few times, so, you know, I was enjoying it, even though I played it, I beat it, I started over. You know, it was that fun. And all the music is just pumping like this. You know, some of it's kind of a slower pace, a little bit more ambient, like, depending on the situation, like, if you're just kind of gliding around before you hit up, like, another cluster of enemies. And that's the other thing, it's just throwing enemy after enemy after enemy. Like, you'll have, like, just so many things going on the screen, like, you know, your targeting systems, and depending on what weapon you're using, like, if you're using, like, the multi-homing laser thing, like all the targets that bling up and then it just shoots and bam, it's just, yeah. Then that's when the music gets really pumping and, like, you know, really just gets you going. Speaking of which, I know I listed off, like, four composers for this song, but these are all the people that have worked collectively on the game's OST, but the one who composed this specific song was Toshiyuki Kakuta, so that's who we're gonna put our targets on right now. So he got started doing freestyle board in 99 in 1997, wanted to be a sound data analyzer for Beatmania GB2 Gacha Mix. Would do a few other Beatmania games, Guitar Freaks Append Second Mix, Dance Dance Revolution Club version on the Dreamcast, and then going up, more Beatmania, and then of course Zone of Enders, the first one. Did additional rhythm loop on Metal Gear Solid 2, more Beatmania, just a lot of, like, so much Beatmania. Metal Gear Solid 2 Substance, which was the extra edition of Metal Gear Solid 2. Skipping all the Beatmania, he did Yu-Gi-Oh! The Dawn of Destiny, Metal Gear Solid The Twin Snakes, which was the dual Metal Gear and Metal Gear Solid 2 on the GameCube. So much Beatmania. The Zone of Enders, The Second Runner, Mars, which was the 2018 re-release of, I think, remaster and re-release of this game. All that to say is that this boy did way too much Beatmania. Now, a fun little tidbit is that I still have my physical copy of this game in its case, and I had the first one, but I had lent it to a friend, and then he ended up lending it to another friend, and then he moved out of state. So I didn't have it until just recently, earlier this year. I just stopped at a game shop in the middle of the last place I expected to find one, and there was a copy of Zone of Ender. So now I have both, and at some point, like so many other games I want to do, I may just go back and play through them again. Though knowing that there's this remaster of this Second Runner, I may just do it with that one. And one more little fun fact is that there's a third game in the series, though it's not related to the story of these of the first two. It was released on the Game Boy Advance. It's called Zone of Enders, The Fist of Mars, and it is a strategy tactics game. Think, you know, like Final Fantasy Tactics or even Super Robot Wars, which we started out with. And it follows the story of a 17-year-old boy. There's like a 26-episode story thing, kind of like how like anime. But mostly you're controlling Lev suits. So like I don't know if there's any orbital frames involved or anything, but I remember trying to play it via emulation and it just didn't grab me. So there you go. That's another little thing to check out if you want. So now that brings us to our last track, and it is another one from the 7 Days of VGM Giant Robots, and it's actually going to be one of the ones that I did. And I try not to do this too often because, you know, it's a little, you know, oh man, that guy who does his own VGM podcast plays nothing but his music on it. He plays nothing but his own big music on it. What? But I thought, why not? You know, the other two that I had shared from Toby Comey and Haberchuk were done with the YM2151 sound chip, and this one I'm going to share with you was done with the same. So what this is Final Clash, Blazing Hero Unleashed, from Day 7 of 7 Days of VGM Giant Robots, composed by Rage Cage. Final Clash, Blazing Hero Unleashed, Day 7 of 7 Days of VGM Giant Robots, composed by myself. And I actually, like pretty much with all the other six tracks I made for this one-week thing, is just in a couple hours at night, just before midnight, because that's really the only time I had to write music. So just barely made it on the days that they were meant for. And so what I did, unlike Toby Comey, who stuck with just the one chipset, I did it with various different chips that were available on Deflamask. So, you know, none of them really sounded the same except for the ones I did with the YM2610 and the YM2612. And I didn't even use the same patches there, so, you know. Though I did kind of create like a little story narrative around it. First track I did was called Get Up and Ruckus, Erratic Robo Chaositor, and then I kind of did, you know, things like you're preparing yourself to fight this. There was a desperate battle, which was against Chaositor, and you lose. And then this is basically right after your giant robot is rebuilt and repowered up to go take on Chaositor for the last time. And one of the cool things about this event was that Dan, the you know runner of VGM Academy, actually used the giant gun, like life-size Gundam model that they have in Japan for like the title cards and everything. And here's a cool little story. When I went to Japan in 2015, I actually got to go see that, you know, that one-to-one size fucking model they had there in, I can't remember if it's like Nano Daiba or something like that. It's like, it's near Miraikon, the Hall of the Future. And, yeah, at night it just lit up, and all it did was, like, move the head around with all the sound effects going on and stuff. And this is before they took it down to put the new one up. I can't remember which one they put up, but there's also the other one where it's actually, like, is in, like, the, all the frame stuff, and then it comes out and kneels down, like, it actually moves and everything, and it's, I wish I could see that, but I don't see it happening anytime soon. And there you have it, my take on the Giant Robots theme for VGM. A little different from what Bedroth and Gang did on Very Good Music. But hey, who knows, maybe I might do another one in the future with one of them or more on the show here. So we'll see what the future holds. But as far as what the near future holds, next week I will be doing a focus on a soundtrack that I have come to love so very much, as well as comparing it to an earlier version of this soundtrack. 2 years difference, but hey, you'll find out when it comes. And you know, I want to thank you for coming into VG Emporium. You can find it on all your favorite social medias, so like Twitter and Instagram, though I don't know if they're anybody's favorites. But you can find the show on your favorite podcatchers, such as Apple and Google Podcasts, Spotify, Audible, Amazon Music, as well as on YouTube, where I just post the title cards I make with the audio playing behind it, nothing too fancy. And then you can find myself, Rage Cage, on those oh-so-delightful social medias, as well as on SoundCloud. And you can find Haberchuck and Toby Comey on SoundCloud, as well as Crazy Goji, who suggested the Ranger X track. I'm going to be linking everybody's stuff in the show notes, so you best go check them out.